Absolutely.
Well, and more exciting news on the Minnesota sports front. The NFL draft was last night. Uh-huh. And as most know by now, the Vikings took Michigan quarterback and national champion J.J. McCarthy at number 10.
Yeah, he was fired up to be here. I got a chance to catch up with him one-on-one today, and he says it's a dream come true going to the Vikings. How excited are you to be here in Minnesota and finally get this process behind you with the draft?
Extremely excited, Reggie. I mean, just thrilled to be here. This place is absolutely amazing and just can't wait to get to work, honestly.
This felt like the fit for you from the start, I feel like, in your eyes. Why did it feel so much like home to you?
Obviously, the great tools that are around a young quarterback and learning from a guy like Sam and Nick and Jaron and obviously Coach O'Connell and Coach McCown. It's just a tremendous fit for a young quarterback, and you know, being able to be in this position, I'm extremely blessed, and especially extremely blessed to have Christian Darrisaw and, you know, Brian O'Neill on my two sides. And yeah, I'm just super thrilled to be here and realize it's a beyond amazing opportunity, and I can't wait to take full advantage of it.
Kevin doesn't necessarily tend to like to play rookies just because the offense is so complex and there's so much to learn for a young quarterback, but how will you kind of be a sponge and take it all in and try to hit the ground running?
Just be around the guys and the coaches as much as possible. You know, be the first guy in, last one to leave, really eat, breathe, and sleep football and this playbook, because it is a monster to learn. And, you know, being from the University of Michigan, we had a playbook that was very similar to a lot of NFL schemes. So that transition is going to be pretty smooth. That's what I'm predicting. We don't know yet. But, you know, I love their offense. I love their philosophy of everything. So I'm just going to be a sponge and absorb every little detail that I can.
72% completion percentage last year. But Michigan plays a lot of smash mouth football. What do you say to the naysayers who are like, well, Michigan was a running team and they didn't ask JJ to do much, so we don't really know what JJ can do as a passer?
I guess we're gonna have to find out. That's all I can say, because, you know, last 3 years, you know, there's been a lot of winning. And Coach Harbaugh's philosophy of how he runs his offense has been something he's been doing since he was at USD, and it's been successful for him. So, you know, I feel like there's a lot of different ways to win football games, and that's what I was asked to do there. I'm gonna ask to be doing something different here, and I just can't wait to put that on display and see where it takes this offense and this team.
JJ, I know it's day one, but when it's all said and done, what do you hope your legacy is here as a Minnesota Viking?
That's a great question. I just want to be somebody that, you know, the next generation looks up to on and off the field. You know, be a guy in the community that's always offering a helping hand. Obviously, be successful on the football field and get Lombardi trophies in here. You know, just trying to uplift everybody in a positive manner.
First impression, very likable guy he is. Yeah, so we'll see where he goes. And when he actually will get in the game, I know Sam Darnold probably gets QB1 right away.
Yeah, we'll see how it all pans out for him.